When I see someone say that the largest supply chain attack in history just happened, I stop what I'm doing and I hit the record button and I make you guys a video. Let's jump right into it. Here's what stopped me dead in my tracks. Urgent. I can't write much yet. Okay. The suspense is killing me, but the largest supply chain compromise in NPM history just happened. Packages with 2 billion weekly downloads just got turned malicious. Guys, I literally have made 2 videos in the last couple months about A, NPM packages getting attacked just like this, and extensions and things turning into malware, turning malicious. But here's the email culprit this time. So some NPM maintainers got phished via this email right here. They've confirmed it. The maintainers of these massive packages raised their hands, said, yep, I got owned. And these are very tech savvy people. They maintain massive NPM packages. They're engineers. They're probably worried about writing secure code. They probably think about cybersecurity. I say all that to say anyone can fall for the right phishing email at the right time. They are not to blame here. This is a good phishing email. It looks like it's from NPM, support@npmjs.help. Okay, good fake domain. Our records indicate that it's been 12 months since your last 2FA update. To maintain account integrity, please log in and update this. If you do not, we will lock your account by September 10th. This instills urgency subtly. This is really good. This is like a 10 out of 10 phishing email. It obviously worked really well. So we've got this great write-up from Akito, I don't know how to pronounce it. NPM debug and chalk packages compromised. Those are the big ones, right? So that's why when you get to that 2 billion number, it's some of these ones down here. The debug import and the chalk import, all these different imports with millions of downloads per week. So the long and short of it, I know less people watch these videos as the video goes on. The long and short, if you need to care, is this list right here. Screenshot this. If you were using any of these things at any point in the last few weeks, you need to go check to see if you pulled down the versions that had malware in them. So this isn't code that you wrote. This isn't even code that the people that wrote these packages wrote. Their NPM accounts were hacked and malicious code was put into these otherwise normal packages that you had already included in your code. So even if you did a bunch of due diligence, you did a code review before you included this package turned malicious at some point that was previously and now still a legitimate package. After doing some analysis, what happens? This malware then starts intercepting your traffic. And what it's really looking for is crypto developers and looking for crypto wallets that they can then do all sorts of nastiness on. But since it's doing this browser-based interception, it's actually doing a lot of other clever stuff as well, like rewriting the crypto addresses of transactions while you're on the page. Really just gnarly kind of stuff. So here's the maintainer raising their hand saying, yep, I've been pwned. 2FA reset email looked very legitimate. Only NPM affected. I've sent the email to see if I can get in touch. Sorry, everyone. I should have paid more attention. Not like me. Had a stressful week. We'll work to get this cleaned up. Again, do not blame Josh here. Anyone can fall for a well-crafted phishing email at the right time. He goes, I have no access to my account at the moment. This is in NPM's hands. Because once NPM got word of this massive compromise, they locked down all the accounts associated with this hack. I've seen a bunch of people doing some malware analysis trying to figure out what was going on. So it looks like, let me zoom in a little bit here. It looks like it detects if MetaMask or Ethereum wallets are available. This is analysis of the malicious JavaScript file that implements this cryptocurrency wallet system. I think this is from Claude and doing malware analysis. So, but this lines up pretty well with what I'm seeing in the other research. So here's a good summary. When the wallet is found, it hijacks it. It sets up hooks to various cryptocurrency wallet interactions. So the gnarly part that I saw that it did was this transaction manipulation, right? So if it sees a crypto wallet address on the screen in the browser, it actually silently rewrites the target of that transfer to the attacker's crypto wallet. That's pretty nasty. I haven't heard of anything like that yet. I've heard of wallets being drained, but this is subtle. It's like, hey, if we're on there, let's see how many transactions we can intercept instead of just draining the wallet. Modifies transaction data for token approvals, transfers, swaps. It also does like a string fuzzy match based on a number of wallets to try to find their attacker controlled wallet that looks closest to the attacker's address to see more legitimate. I don't know, maybe they have like similar ending numbers or something like that. If someone's looking and going, yeah, that's probably mine. JavaScript also has access to the clipboard, so it can replace crypto addresses in the clipboard or displaying on the screen. Outgoing transactions get hijacked, redirected to the attacker's wallet. Approval transactions get redirected to drain tokens, and it supports theft across multiple blockchain networks. Pretty gnarly. Seems like this is just JavaScript-based malware from what I'm reading. So it is just in the browser, so it's not persisting on your system at all. Pulling up some more articles about this, it seems like NPM has not yet responded publicly about it, but they have started pulling or locking down the impacted packages. And then this is the maintainer that that fell for the phishing, and they did also contact Porkbun, which is the registrar that that phishing domain is registered with. I like this quote in this article. What makes it dangerous is that it operates at multiple layers, altering content shown on websites, that's wild, tampering with the API calls on the backer end, and manipulating what users' apps believe they are signing. Super, super interesting attack technique on crypto. I'll include this in the description below, but like really quick, obviously you can just list all the NPM packages that are known to be vulnerable to see if you're impacted but with this command. And then also we're gonna wanna pin to the last known good version of it with that second command. If you were doing anything in your package.json that was doing latest or anything like that, there was a chance that you pulled down this malware. All right, guys, really quick one today. I mean, this is obviously a persistent problem. This is already the second time a phishing campaign that looked and smelt like this was targeting NPM users. So if we find more information about this one, we maybe find that this is part of a bigger campaign going on. I'll let you guys know. I also wouldn't be surprised if we start to see this into other areas like Chrome extension, like VS Code extensions, like PyPy. NPM is massive, so it makes sense. It's got a lot of attention on it. But if they are targeting crypto wallets, there are other avenues that they can run the same type of attack and be successful. All right, share this one with anyone that might have been impacted or used NPM in the last few days. Let them know that this happened. I'll keep you guys updated with NPM's response or any more information we get about this one. Follow for more cybersecurity news.